Woohoo! Welcome back. It's been a while since I've been up here, maybe about a month. So, fingers crossed, nothing has changed. It's considered as the weather's been pretty bad. So hopefully, my shelter's not too bad. I can see it, so it looks like from what I can see. So basically today is the day where I'm going to start my observation. So, excuse me, I'm a little bit out of breath. So, still there. So we're going to put out the traps again. Put one here. Maybe one on that tree. And my plan was to put one somewhere here. Maybe here. I might need to get like a stick, shove it in. So I want to record this area here, so I get the wide view of it all, so I can see whereabouts the pine might have come from. So that might give me a better idea of where it could possibly. I don't know if they have nests or a house, or obviously a house as in like where they live, but not actual a house, but I just see where it come from. I know I have actually set my camera on this here, pointing here, and I believe the pine marten did actually walked up onto the walked up on the actual camera and up the tree. So don't know if you can see the screen. So it could possibly live up there, but I don't know. I'm not actually 100% sure how they do it. Double check there's nobody, someone sleeping in my den. Mabel straight in. Look at that. Let's have a quick look inside. Oh, okay. Well, the ground does look a bit moist in there. There's a bit of water in there. I kind of did expect that, but yeah, okay, that's cool. Yeah, so I'm guessing obviously because I'm on a hill here, it's gone down, so obviously I've made a dip, so that's pretty standard that will happen. So, but most of it really, ideally, the shelter is really just to try and hide me and not look too obvious, but it looks so obvious, but best I could do. No, could I made it smaller? Yes. But no. But I got a good feeling that they will come here regardless of that being there. Especially if there's gonna be like food going there every sort of 2 weeks interval, so it'll be good. Maybe we'll enjoy ourselves as per usual. So I'm just gonna start making breakfast, and then we'll start talking more about what I'm gonna be doing today. So let's talk about the equipment. So I'm using these 8-man, I think there's the H70. One's just the H70 and then one's the H74K. I have these cameras quite a long time. My dad actually had one, and when I started photographing the deer, I asked him if I can have it, and he did. So pretty sound with that, and to be honest, I was so glad he did, because I was struggling so bad of trying to figure out where the deer were. So I just set a camera up where I believe I'd seen them before, but not able to catch a photo, and then all of a sudden I was catching some. So I thought, right, okay, I know they're in this area. So I did actually buy 4 more, but I broke not that glass, the glass inside. So every time I film with it, it was filming in red, and it just looked terrible. So that's the trail camera equipment. So yeah, I'm gonna be setting them up, 2 weeks interviews, and then every Friday I might come back up. Wait, get out of there. I might come back up and then just sort of check how they're getting on, maybe put some more food on. I'll tell you what, there's not a lot on this tin. Pretty disappointed, but I will. So probably check them, maybe put some more food down, or just see if they're actually working. Because the last time I put them up here, I'm not sure if it was the cold weather. They sort of recorded it, but then they obviously ran out of batteries, so I don't know where the battery just drained itself out because it's so cold. But I've had them in the cold before and they have worked fine, so I don't know why they did it this time, but oh well, it's just trying now. So we'll try again. The weather's a little bit warmer now in the night, maybe going down to like 3-2, has gone down 0 for the last 2 days. Do that. Probably wonder why I got this, my fallow deer antler. So I was gonna do some photos with it, and it caught my eye out as well. It's quite cool. So I'm gonna do some photos with that in the woods. And if I do find another one, I might actually put it on my den. But I quite like them, so I started collecting. I think I've got like 7 or maybe 6 antlers now from over the years. So. Too bad. I get your nose out of my food. She's had dinner before she came, well, breakfast. And you always want to try eat mine as well, don't you? Look how cool she is. And dinky look. So, got the first one done. Maybe we're getting in the way, too. That's where I'm going to be feeding them. And then I think I'm going to put the second one on here. So if you're looking right that way. So let's go put the second one up. So both cameras are on. Hey, get down, man. Yeah. Oh god, I tell you what, this bit. The reason why I'm gonna record this bit, because this bit's gonna be the most frustrating, annoying thing ever, because obviously I got Mabel here, which is happy to put anything in her mouth. Oh, and I gotta put the jam and peanut butter there. And she's probably gonna go eat it, so I don't know how this is gonna happen. Do I record it? Nah, because I'm only gonna have one hand holding the lead like that and then the other one scooping out. So I'll do it, I'll put the bait down. Put her on the lead as I'm doing it, and then I'll record once I do it, show you what it is, and then happy days. All set, camera set. So we're all ready to go. Oh god, that was hard work, guys. I'm not gonna lie. I think what I might try to do as well, I might try using my GoPro head mount so I could do a bit of a POV, as they call it. So I'm gonna put the rubbish. Oh, you gotta see. How much I love her, she could be hassle. She could be hassle. So put that back in there. Take your rubbish home, guys. It's important. There we go. Take your rubbish home. So yeah, basically, that's it for this episode. I know it's a bit of a short one. But yeah, so basically, third step of the project. Hopefully, fingers crossed, no one steals my cameras, because that'd be so annoying. And hopefully in 2 weeks time we can catch some pine marks again, which I kind of feel quite confident that we will, and maybe some badgers, because the badgers love the peanut butter, and maybe the fox. So who knows, guys. But yeah, thank you for watching this episode, and hope you have a great day. See you later.